What's up, guys? It's your boy, That's It Zach here, also the fighting therapist. And for today's video, we're gonna cover what's better, volume or intensity when it comes to workout. And we got a friend here today. What's your name?
Nicole.
Nicole, you wanna say hi?
Hi.
So, before we start the video, guys, don't forget, like, subscribe, hit that notification bell so you guys do know when these videos do come out. And if you want first come, first serve to this information and content, down below in the first link, there's something called giveaways. It's my newsletter. You guys are gonna get all the info before the YouTube video comes out about a month ahead. So I really suggest you guys jump on that so you know all this free content beforehand. All right, let's get right into it. So before we go into what's the difference between volume and intensity and what's more beneficial for you guys when it comes to athletes or just individualized people that aren't athletes, first gotta understand what's the difference between them. So volume is gonna be the amount of work that you put per session, per week, per mesocycle, per macrocycle, and intensity is gonna be how hard of an effort that you're actually pushing into each of those workouts. For example, when it comes to intensity, people say, I'm gonna do this many reps, this many sets for 80% of my 1RM, 85% of my 1RM, or if we put it on a cardiovascular basis, it's gonna be, I'm going about 85% of my max heart rate, 60% of my max heart rate. So that's the intensity that we're pushing at. So now that you guys kind of get an idea of what's the difference between both, which one do I think will be more beneficial if we're kind of put to a choice between volume and intensity? I'm gonna say intensity. Now here's the reason why. If I were to go to the gym and do four sessions, which would be my volume, I'm hitting it for the week, I'm doing four sessions. Within each of those sessions, I'm doing about 3 to 4 sets per exercise. So at the end of the week, I have a total of roughly 12 to 16 sets. That's my volume per week. Now, if I want to put an intensity to it, if I wanted to do more volume, but my intensity isn't high, then I'm not really gonna be gaining any strength, any new hypertrophy. I'm not really gonna stimulate anything. Whereas if I went into the gym, let's say less than 4 days, maybe I only went 3 days, and I was doing 3 sets at 85 to 90% of my 1RM, of my max, whether it's for strength training, resistance training, or whether it's just for cardio, I'm definitely gonna elicit a better change, a better hypertrophy change. I'm gonna grow a lot better, I'm gonna get a lot stronger, I'm gonna get a lot faster due to the intensity being high. So when it comes to the difference between is volume better over intensity, I would say the opposite. Volume and intensity pretty much work on a graph that I'm gonna put right up here, and they cross each other. So as volume goes up, intensity will come down. As intensity goes up, volume will go down. And you wanna be careful there. But for me, if I'm only limited to a certain amount of times in the gym, like we said, 3, intensity is gonna be my priority so I could get the bang for my buck, right? Quality over quantity, that's what we want. We don't wanna just do a whole bunch of reps that we call in the sport world garbage. Garbage miles, garbage reps, just doing stuff with no purpose, no real intensity, nothing where you can progress throughout your weeks. So to summarize everything and be really simple, I'm gonna put it into contents of an MMA fighter, okay? Right now I'm training roughly 2 to 3 times a day, Monday to Friday. I take my Saturday, Sundays as recovery days. Now the volume there is pretty high, but this is where the intensity is gonna change. So on certain workouts, let's say Monday, Wednesday, Friday, my intensity is very high because I have jiu-jitsu scenarios where my heart rate is pretty much at 80 to 90%, right? Then also I'm doing sprints on those days. So I'm working on my lactic acid threshold. So that means my heart rate's over 95 to 100%. I'm really trying to push it. Those are my very intense days. On other days, as the volume goes up throughout the week, I'm taking intensity down. So I don't overtrain and I don't put myself in that dip where I can't recover and my body's not used to that yet. So when it comes to the intensity and volume, we're trying to play with it. This is just as an MMA fighter, but for a normal person or someone that wants to train like an athlete, you're better off sticking the volume low in the beginning, make the intensity high, and then gradually work up and play with that inverse graph when it comes to volume and intensity, right? Like Nicole here, how many times do you train a week? Well, my dad. Twice? Once? 3 times? Is it hard every single time?
Yeah.
He pushes you really hard, right?
Yeah.
And you sweat a lot?
Yeah.
Hard to breathe, right?
Yeah.
3 times a week, that's what you guys wanna do. Push that intensity high if you only got 3 times a week. Stay tuned for the next video on episode 2 where we're gonna hit how much volume should you do per week, per mesocycle. That's gonna be the next video, so stay tuned. You're gonna finish it, so we're gonna go punch. Headbutt.
What?
Headbutt. Elbow. Knee. Peace.